What's up, everybody? My name is Trophy Nut, and welcome back to Dark Souls 3. You might be thinking, hey Trophy Nut, what are you doing back in the Undead Settlement? Well, apparently, I'm a big blind doofus, and I missed something over here in the area where the arrows come down. There is another item here, and it's another batch of ashes. Someone mentioned that I missed that, and therefore, I came back for it. Let's check that out. I also found out that you can't actually be hurt anymore by those arrows if you're even hit by them. So you're pretty much invulnerable to anything that giant throws at you. But let's check out those ashes. Mortician's Ashes. Umbral ash of a resident of the Undead Settlement who made a living burying corpses. With this, the Shrine Handmaiden will prepare new items. So that will enable us to unlock another set of items in Farron Shrine with the Shrine Handmaiden. So see you there in a second. Let's see what the Handmaiden has in store for us. There
gracious.
We go.
Passing fine ash thou hast given. Let this ash bestow nourishment.
Nourishment?
I only hope these new wares content thee.
Yes, I do hope too. I hope that too. So, let's see. There's a few more embers. Mosses that I can buy. Oh, this is interesting. Grave key. Key to the barred door leading from the sewer below the undead settlement to a moist grave. The grave, which no longer receives visitors, was once the site of a statue of Valka, goddess of sin, and was believed to pardon wrongdoing and lift curses. Interesting, I want that. Is there anything else? Maybe a few shields and etc. Oh, I can buy the Sage's Big Hat. It is, however, 10,000 souls.
Ashen Whitewall.
So thank you, Shrine Handmaiden. Let's check out that key immediately. So let's head back to the dilapidated bridge. Because I kind of know where that key fits, I think. Well, maybe I should explain this. Since I edit these episodes with mostly a recording session in between, I kind of see some things in the recordings that I missed, because there's another thing I wanted to show you in the end that I missed. And therefore we have these little in-between episodes where we go back and check out the things I've missed, because there's going to be a lot more that I've missed. There we go, and I should be able to enter, because it's this door, I think. Yeah, there we go. Without alerting that big rat. Is that a ladder? Yeah, that's a ladder. Probably wouldn't be a bad thing to just jump down there, but the key said it led to a statue of Valka, to a moist grave. Is that a statue of Valka? Loincloth. Yeah, that's a statue of Valka, alright. So Valka seems to have a mask on her face. Ooh, request absolution, request dissolution. That's probably to forgive your sins if you have hit any NPCs or something like that. Is there anything else around here? Seem to be a lot of skeletons in here. Maybe hidden compartments. A lot of tombstones. It does continue over there. Red-hilted halberd. I'm gonna try out every wall though. Let's check out the halberd. Long-hilted weapon mixing spear and axe. The red-hilted halberd is associated with clerics. Can be thrust like a spear or swept sideways like an axe, making it a versatile weapon effective against multiple foes. Okay then. Oh, there's that branch. Same tree, Belvine. Sacred chime for casting miracles of the gods. A Belvine cut from a small saint tree that has been meticulously tended to. Saint tree Belvines are customary in the far north and allow for faster casting than ordinary sacred chimes. And also allows for that small recovery. HP recovery. So that's the thing that we found near the Cathedral of the Deep, but I couldn't find then. I wonder why I stopped looking for it. Time for stabbing in the back. What? Are those skeletons gonna come to life? Oh god. There is a sword over here. Yeah. Okay. Oh, these guys have the exact same animations as before. Okay. Do they stay dead? That's the most important question. Soul of an unknown traveler. Hidden walls. Apartments. No. Okay. It stays awfully quiet. Wary of ambush. Yeah, because these guys look like they're gonna resurrect. What's this guy up to? So this does seem to go further. Interesting. Thought this would be a little side route, but it's getting more interesting. Do we get to go down below? Okay. So where? Oh yeah, okay, we're below that bridge that leads towards the tower with the giant. There is a crystal lizard over there, which I might try to... Oh fuck. Okay, fuck this. Ooh, am I running into a trap? Or not? Is this a trap? I feel like it's a trap. No, 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 no. Yeah, okay, there we go. Okay. Knew something like that could happen, because those pot-wearing guys are up there. Two datnet charts for my trouble. And anything on the other side. This keeps going. I think that will finally get back up top with that guy over there. Oh, you can even see him. Remember that guy? The guy with the giant hammer and the falcon armor? He's still there. Try up, yeah. Okay, so this is a way. No. So we'll probably end up near him, because I've seen in the recording that there is actually another route up there. So there's one rat. It's incredibly dark in here. Oh! Okay, this might be a mistake. Okay, well, I'm not gonna take any chances. Die, bitches. So that's not all of them. There we go. Okay, that were a lot of rats. Holy crap. And it is still pretty dark in here. Saint's Talisman. Nothing here. Someone up. What's this? Wait a second. There's something. Oh, probably a bug. The walls not exactly aligned with each other. It doesn't mean it's an illusory wall, apparently. Okay then. Never mind. Let's check out that other charm. Because that was another charm, wasn't it? Here, Saint's Talisman, medium for casting miracles of the gods. Ivory talismans are given only to women clerics, and fate greatly affects their effectiveness. There is a certain frailty to this talisman, which undermines their steadfastness granted by its skill. And the skill is unfaltering prayer, temporarily increases poise while casting miracles, preventing enemy attacks from interrupting prayer. Interesting. Works while equipped in either hand. So that's that. So let's get back up here. And if I'm correct, that should bring us back to that burly knight near the entrance of the tower. If we're not ambushed by anything else. Ooh. Okay. Hello.
Who is there?
Is that?
Someone there. Anyone?
Is that, that woman from the Way of White in Dark Souls 1?
Please, whoever you are, touch me.
Excuse me?
The dark surrounds me, nibbles at my flesh.
Little
creatures. They never stop biting.
You look
so
like a nun.
Hold out your hand and touch me.
Okay. Touch. I already have a dark sign, so I don't think it can get any worse.
Ah, oh, yes, there you are. So close, indeed.
This is getting really sexual.
And I am not entirely alone, just yet. Praise the merciful gods above.
Okay, prayer. Is she gonna disappear?
Oh, well, forgive me. I am Irina of Karim. I came to this land so that I might be a firekeeper.
Okay, you look the part.
Your touch has freed me from the darkness. You are a champion, then.
Well, Yol keeps telling me that.
I am weak and unfit to tend the flames.
Well,
but if it would not trouble you, might I enter into your service instead?
Of course, my lady. Yeah, sure.
Oh, thank you, sweet champion. I shall take my vows. I, Irina of Karim, solemnly swear to serve you.
And she's gonna disappear, isn't she? Yeah, there she goes. Puff of smoke. Praise the mount. Praise the mount. Ah, overwhelming. Okay. Time for miracles. That seems more appropriate. Anything here? Anything in her cell? I'm a bit paranoid about the illusory walls, because I haven't found a single one. Nope. Okay, so now this is the path that I saw. Yeah, I missed completely. And I'm assuming that we probably wouldn't have been able to open this door from this side. Although it is a nice side route to getting here without needing to cross the bridge. Nice. Okay. So that kind of concludes everything I wanted to do in the Undead Settlement. So I'll probably head back to the... is this going down or up? Yeah, okay. I'm probably going to head back to the swamp, to Farron's Legion, to try and open that, since we already snuffed out two of the three flames. So we're almost done there, and then we should be able to gain, well, access to the Legion. That's what they told us anyway. So, see you in the swamp in a second. So, welcome back to Farron Keep. Just in case you have forgotten what we were supposed to do here, there are three of these columns in this place that have a fire above them. And we need to snuff out the candles at... and I think that's one of those. I think we need to snuff out the candles at the bottom of each tower. When we do that, a brazier is lit near the gate that we need to go through. The gate that bars us away from the wolf's blood. Sounds all really fancy. And I'm hoping we can get to that in this episode. Oh, that's that gate. Great. Okay, but we haven't found that third... Okay, there's another crab. That third flame yet. So everything here is still poisoned. And there's leeches hanging from the walls. Of course, I have a solution for that. There he goes. There are a lot of those leeches here. And they seem to be pretty magic resistant. There we go, let's loop around a bit. Hopefully there's no leeches above me, that's what I wanted to say. And let's see what they were guarding. An undead bone shard, great, so we can upgrade our Estus flask the next time we're at Firelink Shrine. What the hell is that? That's not a tree, and it's moving. I still don't know what these things are that are hanging from the trees either. Holy shit, there are a few of them. And there is a ladder over here. Now that makes me more curious than anything else. There we go. What the f... Okay. Did every slug do that? There's a lantern attached to this ladder, so that's usually a good sign. Let's hurry it up a bit, because this seems to be high up. And I'm already scared a bit. Don't want to fall off now. Where the hell are we? Hello? Another? Wait, what? Oh, hi. I knew they were talking about guard dogs. The guard dog of Farron, but I thought they were talking about a human, since those two NPC invaders were also called guard dogs. Anything else around here before I poke that dog? There's a set of stairs. Look at this. This is cool. Oh, but I can use this vista to check. Oh, there's the last flame I need to snuff out. Seems awfully close to where we were at the beginning. Might be actually better to warp over there and then do that. But first, since we're up here... Oh! No, 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 no. No, 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 no. Why is this wall so weird? More Twinkling Titanite! Hell yes! Okay. Something ahead. Yeah, I know. Wait, aren't we back where we came from right now? Yeah, okay. So before I'm gonna take out that dog, maybe this message was talking about a... Okay, yes. Our first illusory wall! Praise the sun! Yes, okay. Dream Chaser's Ashes. This is the Ashes episode. I think I'm gonna call it that. Lots and lots of ashes. So let's check that out. Dream Chaser's Ashes. Umbral ash of one who dreamt of joining the Undead Legion. With this, the Shrine Handmaiden will prepare new items. In the end, the Dream Chasers who wandered aimlessly in the rotted forest found a sense of fulfillment. He's also holding something in his hand. Looks like another talisman, but... Okay, now this dog. What does it do? Like a dream. Doesn't seem... Is he moving? Doesn't look like he's moving. But I'm even afraid to light the bonfire. I can't go up even. What's this do? I'm not far from the other bonfire, so I'm not really sure where that bonfire. There's something I missed in that tower, right? Okay. Wow. Holy shit. Look at that. That looks like a pretty picture. Wallpaper. Okay, and why does this keep going? I'm not sure if I should have killed the dog. Try ranged battle. What the fuck is that? Danger zone ahead. Yeah, no shit, Sherlock. Ranged battle, but I might as well try. Kinda looks like that other dragon we fought. And it kinda looks like the asylum demon as well. Oh. What? I'm under you. Holy shit. Okay. Kinda dodge that. That was stupid. Might want to switch back to the sword, because this isn't really working. Holy shit, I dodged that again. Oh, wow, okay. So ranged isn't really working. So there's two bigger non-boss creatures here. We have the dog. I'm just gonna try and activate that bonfire and see what happens. I think you're gonna ignore most of this. You're not gonna really attack me. Well, except for these guys. There we go. Let's go back up. And let's try and activate that bonfire. Not that I'm really sure what that would do. Aside from getting me killed. I mean, it's not like From Software to put two of those really close together. And I kinda do not want to kill this thing. Since it's not really attacking me. Oh, I can pray to it. Legion Etiquette. Asked to join Covenant. Well then I'm sure not to to kill you. I'm gonna keep that off for now. Since I don't wanna just bind me to that Covenant yet, because I think it's more about invasions and PvP, that Covenant, since we were attacked by two of those guard dogs of Farron in the Crucifixion Woods. But I'm gonna assume I can't block those strikes from that demon, so I'm gonna go two-handed and try and be smart about this. Listen to me talking smart about this. Like I've been ever smart about these things. Okay. So, souls retrieved. And now let's pummel this big guy. Hey, dude. Can you help me? I'm lost. So rolling seems to work. And then just be patient about this. Oh fuck! Okay, didn't expect that. I'm gonna go full health for this. Ooh. Ah, dodge through that. Yeah, okay, never mind. Goodbye. Okay. Wow, magic actually does a lot more than my regular attacks. So this might actually work. Ah, for fuck's sake. Ooh, that might have been a mistake. And there he goes! Goodbye! Soul of the Stray Demon, it is actually the Stray Demon. But completely petrified. Interesting. Well, it is dead anyway. Is there anything else we should have come up here for? Seems to be another pilgrim on the other wait, what? There's a message over there. Can I open this gate? Doesn't look like it. Maybe on the other side here? No. Oh. Oh. This is something. That's probably to get the elevator back up. There are a few items over there which I want to have. So that's that. An ember. A great axe. And another ember. And this seems to be collapsed. So you can see a lot from here. And this is a part of the bridge that's closer to Blotric Castle. But first, let's check out everything we just got. So the soul, here we go, soul of a stray demon. It is actually a boss soul, used to acquire numerous souls. The stray demon, now lacking even a trace of flame, was once the gatekeeper of Lothric. So is that a hint that this is the same place again, like Dark Souls 1? It always is, but it's starting to be a bit ridiculous that they keep reusing everything. And then the great axe resembling a hunk of raw iron. If one possesses the inhuman strength required to lift a weapon, the great heft of its attacks will send foes flying. However, since every swing makes use of one's entire body, attacks leave the wielder wide open to retaliation. Okay then. So your typical strength-based weapon. So we could drop down there, but I don't think, aside from that, that there will be anything of interest over here. Might as well try. Drop. Whoa. Okay. I'm way too enthusiastic every time I do that. Oh, this looks like a point of no return. Well, this doesn't, but this one does. Okay. Still alive. Okay. Ah, great. Someone's waiting on the... Oh, now I know where we are. This is where that dragon crash landed. And that's where we found Yol. Let's have my Estus flasks at the ready. Oh, this dragon is going to be still alive, isn't he? Okay. A double large titanite shard. Good dragon. Lightning spear, awesome. Okay then. You're stone like the other ones? Okay. Anything else here? So that's the explanation of... Oh, there's something over there. That's the explanation why there was a message on the other side here. I do want to have a slash at those. I don't really care. Heavy gem. You guys are idiots anyway. Okay. Where's the other one? Okay. Yeah, there's the fast one. Let's deal with this guy first. And then this little fellow. And then just kill the spear guy just because I'm thorough. Hi. Poke. Yeah, put your shield up, man. Or you'll die. Okay then, so... Is there anything here, or is this just for show? Doesn't look like there's any items here. And then if we go up here... dead crystal lizards. Something I do not want to drop down to. We could get to the other side of the wall back here. Huh, it's a core. Core? Huh, core? I don't get it. And nothing here as well. Because this looks incredibly the same as up there. So, are we able to open that gate? Maybe. Maybe not, because I don't see a lever. Huh, it's a poor soul. Hello? Are you alive or dead? Oh, I seem to be dead. So I assume the only way to get back to the other side is by dropping down from above here. And that will get back to the wolf. Drop. And drop. Anything else? Something with an item I can drop onto? Doesn't look like it. Okay. Well, that was nice. A bit of a wide open area, but still nice. But now I'm gonna go back to my little poochie. My little doggy doggy. A wolf. Kinda looks like a wolf, so might as well call it a wolf. Motion blur! Oh. Right here. Let's activate the bonfire. Just to heal up really quickly. And, well, I'm gonna take a little break next to my furry little friend here. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like this video right here on YouTube. So, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you enjoyed it exceptionally well. If you enjoyed watching any of my videos, so don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done already. So thank you guys enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or stream. Goodbye!